Let's just go across live to Sam Daniel, who's joining us from DMK headquarters. Sam, is there any are you seeing any activity or anything which at all is reflecting the numbers that we're seeing, that it's now quite likely to be MK Stalin as chief minister?
That's right, Vasu. Already at least a few hundred party workers have gathered at the DMK headquarters. No celebration, but certainly they are cheering, sloganeering. And with me, the DMK spokesperson and MP, Mr. TKS Elangovan. So thank you so much for your time. Congratulations. It looks like the DMK is all set to form the government in Tamil Nadu. But are the numbers disappointing to you? It seems you may be around 140 plus.
No, my expectation is around 180. Because in the initial stages, there were the postal votes which were counted earlier. And we had our own doubts because postal vote, we said that 80 plus people should not be given postal votes. But the government, the election commission had given it. So under threat or under pressure, those people would have voted for the ruling party. So when the polling, first stage, second round, third round goes on, I think we will get more victories, and my expectation is around 180 plus.
Okay. Not less than when do you think you are forming the government?
Maybe in the coming week, because victory, the MLA should get their victory certificates and then assembly here, elect their leader. There are procedures. The government, the incumbent government should resign, the governor should call us, and we will fix a date and time.
Is it, in a sense, a repeat of the 2016 verdict, but switching sides? The AIADMK is emerging to be a stronger opposition the way you did last time.
I don't expect that. The ADMK will get lesser number of seats than what is now shown in the channel. They will not cross even 40. That is my
question. Is it a vote for the DMK or is it a vote against the BJP? How do you interpret it?
It is a vote for the change in governments in the state. People have wanted a change in the present government, and they are totally against the government of India and BJP government. So on both counts, they have voted for DMK.
How much of this would you attribute to Prashant Kishore's strategy?
No, he had projected our leader in a better way, and he had done his work successfully.
What will be the top priority for your government, sir? COVID is again, the numbers are rising in Tamil Nadu, both in terms of death count and in terms of positive cases. Chennai is turning into a hub now, 5,000 plus cases.
Yes, that is our first priority. And both the state and the central government had failed in controlling COVID. We will see that the situation changes and people get proper treatment and go home early. We will ensure the health safety of our people.
Will the swearing-in be a kind of a grand affair, or does the party look at a very low profile?
No. It depends on the situation at that time. Because now with the COVID period, we will, I think our leader, as he said today, that we will enjoy the victory from our homes. He will do something. He will issue a statement in that regard.
But Mr. Stalin also have a deputy chief minister, as he himself was deputy.
I can't speak on the cabinet formation. That is too early.
Lastly, were political parties like the DMK also in a way responsible for the spike in numbers? During the campaign, you had large gatherings with no COVID norms being followed.
You're right, but a campaign is a campaign. We can't stop people from coming and meeting the leaders. But our campaign was restricted and we did not go. It is the public, common public, who had come to attend Mr. Stalin's meeting. So we cannot blame the party.
Right.
The people wanted to listen to Mr. Stalin. They have gathered. And we have, as much as possible, we have restricted the crowds.
Thank you so much. And again, congratulations, Mr. Elangovan, the DMK spokesperson and MP talking to us. Vasu, it's over to you.
Okay, all right. Thanks very much indeed, Sam. So the DMK there, we actually saw some pictures of some kind of celebrations, a little bit of dancing with some DMK supporters who have come out, you know, even though the EC had said that these have to be kept, I mean, virtually had said you can't actually have celebrations, but that is Indian politics for you. And you can see them holding up a poster of Stalin and breaking into a little jig at DMK headquarters in Chennai.